Yesterday class we discussed about how we can fetch the how we can enter the data, how we can create a table dynamically. Basically we see all those operation, okay, making a connection, process a query, insert a data, then how we are supposed to update the data, okay, and after that I convert the entire function into the menu driven program. So these are the number of lines of code whatever we did yesterday. So today I am going to show you how we can fetch the data. Okay, how we can fetch the data from MySQL. This entire things are happens to enter the data, to modify the data, okay, to process your query. So this code, the last time that we discussed in great detail, how you can enter the data, how you can create a table, how you can create table dynamically, how you can process your query. Now I'm showing you how we can fetch a data from the MySQL. Okay, so the concept is this one. So let me elaborate this thing first dramatically, then I will move to the practical part. So this last time we discussed, this one is your database and this one is the Python script. With the help of the Python script, you are supposed to enter the data into this MySQL. Now today's task is to fetch the data from MySQL, okay, with the help of this Python script, and you are supposed to print the data on the console screen. Okay, you are supposed to print the data on the console screen, that on the CMD. So that is our task for today. So fetch, I already told you there are the 7 methods, as we've seen few of them yesterday, the execution, cursor, connection, okay, and this one is the import the external package. Now we will see the remaining, you know, the remaining methods, the especially the fetch. Okay, the fetch is the remaining last method that we will understand about it into the great detail. How we will fetch the data, I will show you today. So first thing, I will do all the things into the shell, so to make the things very clear and very easy. Then I will come back to this file again, and we will try to cover it into the great extent. So till now, if you have any doubt regarding these concepts, please ask me. Before moving further, if anyone having any question, any doubt regarding this, please ask me, as we show you how exactly the code standards are made. Okay, so with the help of the function, I meant everything into the function, so the lives become more easy. Rather than to writing the concept again and again, I just calling the function into my while condition, okay, into my while loop, as at the end of this code, as we describe this code into the menu driven. Okay, so first I will show you how exactly the things are work, then we will come back to this file. Okay, so first what we have to do, I am copying the code for my convenience, and okay, so first we have to import this package, as we already discussed into the last video so many times. And the first and the most important is you have to create a connection. Okay, so you have to create a connection. So I am making a connection over here. I am exactly copying all the things from this, okay, for saving the time and for my convenience. So now I am making a cursor. I made a cursor. The cursor is the object. With the help of the cursor, you are supposed to fetch the data. Okay, so these three things are important one. Otherwise you will get the error message. If these three things are not happen, then you will get the error message. So now I am moving to my MySQL. First let me check how many tables are there and what are the basic data inside that. So my password is this one. Okay, so I'm use Python Ireland. Okay, I'm using the database name. The database name is the Python Ireland. I'm showing show tables. Yesterday we created two tables, select star from employee. Okay, employee. So I am entering into the employee table. So these are the record that I have to fetch. Okay, these are the record that I have to fetch. So I am fetching these record. So I am always using the word that is the fetch. The meaning of the fetch is, now you are fetching this data through this code. Okay, through this code. You are fetching this data through this code. And after that, you are displaying this data on the console screen into the proper manner. So now this concept is called fetching the data. And we already know how many types the fetch is used. The fetch all, fetch one, okay, and then fetch many. So these are the various possibility to use the concept of the fetch. Okay, so I am showing you how we can fetch the data. So this one is my table, the employee table. The connection has been done. The connection is established over here. The host name is the local host, and the user is the root, and the password is 12345, and the database is the name of the database, that is the Python Ireland. So after making a connection, I create a cursor object, because we know with the help of the cursor, you are supposed to fetch the data, you are supposed to write the data, and you are supposed to display the data. And whatever operation that you want to perform over here in the one line statement, whatever the operation that you want to perform here inside the database, the cursor is mandatory. Without cursor, it is impossible. Okay, so now I am moving ahead. Now I am showing you how you can fetch the data from this this particular, you know, the Python script. So here I implement a query, select star from employee. Okay, select star, the same query that you have to implement. So for implementing this query, what I am doing, I am writing this query into the same manner. Okay, cursor dot execute, the same thing, everything is same. Okay, the cursor dot execute. Now cursor dot execute, what do you want to execute? I want to execute select star from my table, employee. Okay, employee table. Okay, now it is returning me two. What is the meaning of this? Because in this data set there are two rows, and cursor has been read it out. With the help of this execution, the cursor has been read it out all these two rows. Okay, so now I want to display them on the screen. For displaying them, we have to fetch them. The cursor is read out. Okay, let's suppose this one is the concept. Just imagine it. Okay, let's suppose this one. Okay, now this concept has been done. Just imagine it. It is read it out. Okay, it is selected. With the help of this, just imagine to graphically understand the concept graphically. When I execute this cursor dot execute, these things has been happened. That's mean the whatever the data that you want to be display, you want to be, you know, represent onto the console screen, that data has been selected. So after selection of it, now we have to fetch the data. Okay, so for fetching, we know it, row is equal to cursor dot fetch. Now fetch one, if you do the fetch one, the only one record will be there. Okay, I just perform the fetch one. So now I print the row, you are getting the output. Okay, you are getting the output. Now you can check it out. Okay, exactly the same first row that I achieved over here. Okay, the second row. Let's suppose I perform fetch all. So I have two records. So two records will be display. Okay, two records will be display. So why it show only one record? Because my cursor is, after processing it, fetch one, the same concept, the cursor is blinking over here. Okay, the cursor is blinking over here. Now after that, I read the concept fetch all means I read the entire data. So doing the same thing again, I am implementing this. Okay, I am implementing this. Now I am performing fetch all. Now you can check it out. The complete data is read. Okay, the complete data is read from this MySQL, and in which format? Inner tuple. You can check it out. This concept is called tuple. Okay, when I read the data from the MySQL, the data is came in the form of the tuple. Okay, so you can check it out. This is the nested tuple, or you can say the inner tuple concept. Tuple inside tuple. Okay, so for displaying this data, we know it very well. For I in, okay, I in range, or you can say simply row. Okay, row. So this one is a row, and I am printing of I. That's it. You are displaying now into the exact manner. Now you can understand the code, why we learn that concept, the printing of the, you know, the printing of this one. Okay, the printing of this one. Now exactly the same code is there if you want to represent data into the proper format, rows and columns. Okay, so same code I am making over here for displaying the data onto the screen. As I already discussed n number of times, that's why we are performing that type of scenarios. Now you get the clarity. Okay, because data is not coming into the appropriate format, it is coming into the tuple by tuple. But I want that data into the form of the rows and column. For printing this data into the rows and columns, what I have to do, for I in range, exactly the same function. Okay, the same whatever we made at that time. So length of row, and again for, okay, j in range of I, and then what you have to do, print of row of, you can say I. Okay, and end is equal to this one, and then after that you are supposed to print it. That's it. Now okay, I'll get some error. I don't know why I getting the error, so let me check it out. Tuple object, something I did wrong, something what I did wrong. So let me check it out. Okay, tuple object is not callable. Why it's not a callable? Tuple object is not callable. Sorry, I did a mistake over here. I used the wrong parenthesis. So I have to do the slicing. For the slicing I have to do this. Okay, so now you can check only one row. Why it's one row? I don't know. First I have to again read the data. I read the entire data and inside this I fetch. Okay, now inside this code, okay, why I get only one record? Because I didn't press over here plus one, as already discussed in graded. So now you can get again the data is still not into the exact format. Okay, for getting it into the exact format, what you are supposed to do? So row and j. Okay, now you will get the data into the exact format. Again still it is not into the exact format. So why it's get data is something like this. Let me print this row. Okay, so where we are doing a mistake? Here we are doing a mistake. It's a okay row of, okay, row of zero. So here you are supposed to use this. Again error. So I'm doing mistake somewhere. I don't know where I'm doing mistake. For row of I, tuple object is not, cannot be interpreted as an integer. So why, where I am doing a mistake? I don't know. Row of, yes, I think this will work fine. Yes, this would work fine. Yes, this one I am doing a mistake because I am iterating. Okay, iterating the row of, simply I am taking the row of I and I am saying okay this one is, and iterating this range. So it's a wrong syntax. So you have to find it out the length of this. Okay, then length will be executed, exact the same code will be there. Now you can understand why we are making such kind of code. This is the triangle series. The exact 90% of code is same, but this time, as I already told you into that section, that time we will use this code and we will fetch the data from some external sources and we will display the data into this form. Now I think the picture would be clear. Everyone, this picture is clear or not? Because this code is exactly. Sorry.
So there's one question for you, right?
Yeah, please.
You know the way you have used the sign of list. Why is that?
Sir, this is not a valid question.
I know that, like, you know, but
this concept is called slicing concept. What?
I know slicing, all right.
Yeah, okay.
But are you doing the slicing of I?
Yes, you can check like this. Let's suppose this one is my data, okay, inside this. So 1, 2, 3, okay, and comma. Again, this is a concept of the nested tuple. Okay, so this one is a data. I want to print it out. R of 0 of 0. So now what output I will get? I will get this one. I will get this one. The same thing I am doing over here. I am getting one by one and I am printing into the same line. Okay, I am printing. Where is my output? This one. I am printing into the same line with the help of this end. If I don't implement the end, you will get 101, then into next line Ravi, then you will get into next line this and this, again into this, and one by one you will get the entire data into the one line. This one you can say the vertical line. So for horizontaling, the same concept.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, you know, because it's coming because we are using list, right? So it should come as a list.
No, it's coming as a, in the form of the tuple, not list. But the concept is same, na? List and tuple, you can do the slicing and indexing because these are the ordered pair. Okay, there is no difference. Only difference is the one is the mutable object and the another one is the immutable. This time, because data is coming from that particular, you know, the MySQL database, at that time the data is came into this format. So you are not supposed to change. By default, if you try to change it, you will get the error message, because this one is original data that is coming from the tables. and this is your final data. Might be this can be your username and this can be your password. Nobody is supposed to change this user and password until you want to give the permission. Okay, so that's where data is coming in the form of the tuples. I think the question is clear. Okay, good. So now come back. Now you understand the concept how we can fetch the data. There is only one command that is called fetch, and rest of the things are depend upon the query on what parameter that you want to fetch. Let's suppose you want to fetch a data from those who are having the salary of greater than this and greater than that, and whose name is this and flana and whatever you want to use. So let me add some record manually. I'm going to add some records manually over here, or we can do the another way. Use our script. Okay, some let me add some data into this. Okay, so we are adding some data over here. So I'm running my code, PySpace. Okay, why it's not showing test connection? Okay, PySpace test connection dot py. Okay, py. Okay, so for insert a value 2, okay, enter the table name employee. Okay, so employee ID 103 this time, employee name this time ZZZ, okay, employee salary this time, make some genuine data, okay, 25,000, employee city CHD. Do you want to add more? Yes. Employee ID 104, okay, employee name. Let's suppose AAA, okay, and the employee salary 26,000, okay, and employee city, let's suppose Mohali, okay, yes, and this time the employee ID is 105, and employee name QQQ, and employee salary 27,000, okay, and the city is, let's suppose LDH. Okay, do you want to add more? Yes. 106. Okay, so employee name, the name of the employee is let's suppose www, and the employee salary 28,000 or 29,000 you can say, and the employee city, let's suppose Londra. Okay, do you want to add more? No. So record inserted. Okay, record inserted. Now check me whether the records are inserted or not into it. So you can check. Yes, all the records have been inserted. Now I'm making it more, you know, the more options over here. So here one option, one function I am making right now. That function will display the data. Okay, to display the data on the screen. So my function name is, after updating, after all these things, now I am making one function, and that function name is, that function name is the def of print. Okay, print data. So it's take two things, cursor and connection. We already discussed in great detail in the last class. And what else? The table name. Okay, table name, it will take a table name. Whatever the table name you will pass, it will display the data according to that. Let me close this, otherwise it will disturb us a lot. Okay, so this is the function, and the code for the function. Now the code for the function. So first I will display the all data. Okay, so for displaying the all data, I'm copying the entire code from here, this one for displaying the data. Okay, this one for displaying the data, control V. Okay, so here and then here,